Today we come together to celebrate the love between two people and their love for God, for family, and of course, Hogwarts. Friends and family of Nicole and Aaron, welcome and thank you for being here and sharing this important moment with them in their lives. We'd also like to take a moment to give recognition to those that could not be here with us today. While they are not here with us physically, Aaron and Nicole feel their love and the support as they are with us in spirit. In dreams, we enter a world that is entirely our own. Sometimes our journey begins with much different dreams than the reality we live in. But the course God takes us down can fill us with more purpose, joy, and love than we could ever imagine. Sometimes we have to choose between what is right and what is easy. Love is a choice, a promise, and a commitment for life. Love is not easy, but flourishes with hard work, with prayer, and faith. It is never too late to learn something new, to forgive, and to love more than you did the day before. Marriage is the clasping of hands, the hearts, the union of two lives as one within the circle of its love. Marriage encompasses all of life's most important relationships. A husband and wife are each other's best friend, confidant, lover, teacher, listener, and yes, even critic. And we can do that because in marriage we say not only I love you today, but also I promise to love you tomorrow, the next day, and always. Differences of habit and language are nothing at all if our aims are identical and our hearts are open. Marriage is also a place of freedom. Freedom to fully express who we are, knowing that you have someone there to catch you when you fall, encourage you when you're discouraged, and applaud your successes. Marriage makes you strong, independently and together. This is all true. These are essential parts of a good marriage, but there are also other important components. Friendship, courage, and even risk, because marriage is a risk, a great and glorious risk when we embark on the adventure in the same spirit. It's also a great responsibility. In the words of Albus Dumbledore, we can't choose our fate, but we can choose others. The consequences of our actions are always so complicated, so diverse, that predicting the future is a very difficult business indeed. However, when you accept that responsibility for someone's heart, there are rewards that you receive when you take risks. You share your journey with your whole heart and let love walk into your life. You find your soulmate. Our soulmates make us feel treasured, safe, and loved beyond our wildest measure. We get the partner and the lover and the protector we've always desired and maybe even needed. This journey will at times be richly rewarding and at other times extremely difficult. But most importantly, it will be a journey that you take together. You're promising and have asked all these people that you love to watch you make these promises, that you want to be with each other for the rest of your lives, and that you will do everything in your power to honor the promises that you're making here today. For their part, the people who love you will always do everything in their power to try to help you hold up your end of the bargain. Aaron, do you take Nicole to be your wife, promising to love her, comfort her, to honor her, respect and care for her for the rest of your life? Nicole, do you take Aaron to be your husband, promising to love him, to comfort him, respect and care for him for the rest of your life? Words are, in my not-so-humble opinion, our most inexhaustible source of magic, capable of both inflicting injury and remedying it. Your recommitment this day is one brief day in time, and although your vows are spoken in a matter of minutes, they're promises that will and should last a lifetime. So, Aaron, if you will now share your vows.
It's only because of you I have loved, and if that would still be broken. So when I say I owe it all to you, it's truer than true. So I promise to be the best husband and father for you, our family, and for you. Most importantly, I'm excited to see your future and grow with you.
And now, Nicole. Please join your hands. Nicole, Aaron, I want you to focus on these hands that are holding yours, and I want you to see the gift that they are to you. For these are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. And these are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you throughout all the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like none other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief temporarily comes your way. These are the hands that will countless times wipe tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. And these are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will give you support and encouragement. And these are the hands that will hold you tight as you struggle through difficult times. These are the hands that will lift your chin and brush your cheek as they raise your face to look into eyes that are filled with overwhelming love for you. And lastly, these are the hands that, even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. May they have the rest. Your rings seal your vows and represent a promise for everlasting love. It's a physical manifestation of the promises joining Aaron and Nicole together. And Aaron, you'll go first as you place the ring on Nicole's left-hand ring finger. Please repeat, with this ring, I meant for Ethel. And Nicole, as you place the ring on Aaron's left-hand ring finger, repeat to him, with this ring, I too meant for Ethel. And now, if you would like to approach. They have chosen to commemorate this union with the sand ceremony. They will fill the hourglass with sand, and each of you will have your own color. The sand represents who each of you are now, and that includes who you were before today. Essentially, it's everything that has made you who you are today and makes you ready to take the next step in life. As the sands intermingle with each other as you pour them, they'll never be able to be separated again. That's how love works. Love exists in itself and continues to take on new meaning as we experience and we give it our personal meaning. The hourglass is an enduring symbol of time. It will now become an enduring symbol of your love and of your marriage. Each time you turn it, the sands will become more intermingled. It's one of those hypnotic actions that you can get lost in. You can dream of what will come and what will continue to make the love that you are as individuals and how you'll continue to complement each other. Perhaps it will remind you of today and your hopes and your dreams and your belief and your choice to stay together, bound by love. You can go ahead and start pouring your sand. Perhaps it will remind you that this too shall pass, because life and love and marriage is like that. It has ups and downs and will turn you around more than once. But may it always remind you of the perfection of this moment on this day. Please join in. Aaron and Nicole, may your marriage be blessed with love, peace, and happiness as you go out into the world and continue your story as a loving couple. Please remember that you are only as strong as you are united. As weak as you are divided, you are protected in short by your ability to love. Aaron and Nicole, you promised each other your love, your devotion, and commitment. You may now seal this commitment with yet another kiss.
Yeah!
Yeah! Can you feel face your guest and get the bouquet? I will present to you Mr. and Mrs. Aaron and Nicole Smith.
Again. Woo!
I love you guys.
There we go.
Papa said, let's go.